Moving on, now we have Stoichea, and which is Sylvan, and the boss unit here, Sylvan King, Magnolia. We have our starter here, Lotte, not sure how to pronounce it, does whatever your source Vanguard does. And we have our starter here, when ridden over by Retas, which is this unit, the grade 2 of course, from your top of your deck, you may reveal one card, which means you don't have to, but you'll probably do it anyways, because why not? You may reveal the top card of your card, and if it is a grade 2 or less unit, then you can call it to a rear guard circle. If it is not, then you may add it to your, then put it in your soul, not add it to your hand. So, you ride Lattice here, and then next turn, So you ride Lattice, reveal top card of the deck, it is a grade 2 or lower. So I can call it to a rear guard circle now. In case it isn't a grade 2 or lower, like for example, you got Sylvan King, which you probably wouldn't want, but if you got unlucky enough, it was a grade 3 like Magnolia, you have to put in your soul. Or if it's the order card. So, I mean, the soul helps. It does. But you want to be careful. You don't want to accidentally soul charge one of your units. Just like in Dark States. And next, we have Lattice. Please focus, camera. Okay, what it does is when ridden over my Magnolia, Soul Blast 1. So, again, the Soul Charge from this unit does help if you do Soul Charge. Soul Blast 1, and from the top of your deck, you may... you have to. Okay, so reveal the top... Soul Blast 1, reveal the top card of your deck. And then, if it is a unit card, you may call it to a rear guard circle. If it is not, add it to your hand. So now, regardless of whatever grade it is, it doesn't matter. If it's the order card as well, then you get to add it to your hand. That's really good. If you got a grade 3, get to call it. If it, you get the order card, you get to add it to your hand. Sorry about that. Here's the order card, by the way. I'll explain what it does later. That's a grade 2. So, when you ride Magnolia over it, reveal top card of your deck. It is a unit. I get to call it to a rear guard circle, and that's it. Oh, sorry, I have Soul Blast. So, yeah, you Soul Blast, then reveal top card, call. Superior calling kind of reminds basically what Neo Nectar does. If it happened to be the order card, you get to add it to your hand. So, yeah, not bad. But it says, just like with Rooks, it's his other skill that makes him more decent. So, his other skill is that when it's in the back row, you can. When it's in the back row, and when this unit attacks the Vanguard, then you can Soul Blast 1 for that battle, he gets power plus NK. So, if you don't know how to, if you don't know what Magnolia does, you might be really confused as to why. This only works if you're at the, if it's at the back row. And I'll be sure to explain, and I'll explain that right now. So, what's it? Here we go. Okay. So, what does Magnolia do? I'll explain its skill. Alright, so when this unit, at the end of the battle, sorry, you can't see it. Okay, at the end of the battle that this unit attacks, counterblast one and choose one of your units. And for that turn, the unit can attack from the back row and get power plus 5k. And if you persona ride it this turn, instead of choosing one, you can choose three. So this allows you to attack from the back row as well rather than boosting, which means you can do way more attacks. That's why you can call Lettuce here to the back row. And now you attack with Magnolia at the end of the battle. Now you can Soul Blast one and choose your unit here, choose your Lettuce. He gets power plus 5k attack. Soul, I don't have another card in my soul, oops. Soul Blast one. And he gets power plus 10, so now instead of being 15, he's 25. Of course, when only attacking the Vanguard, but still. So, that's why Magnolia is pretty good for making more attacks, just like Aqua Force. This is the Stoichea start deck, it's pretty much just Aqua Force. This original Aqua Force, but it doesn't look like the Navy. That's it. So Aqua Force players might enjoy playing this. And then you have other support units that you probably want to use. For example, you have this unit right here. Once per turn. Counter Blast 1, Soul Blast 1. For that turn, this unit gets boost and 5k. So it's a 15k unit. And has boost, so you can, instead of just attacking with it, for example choosing it with Magnolia skill, you can now actually just use this to boost and attack. This will be 15k, right? So that'll be really good. But then again, you are losing another attack, so this means that you really have to decide, you have to like really think about it. You have to think about your units and their placement, whether you want them in the back row or in the front row, because some units have skills that work only in the back row, like Lettuce. Then you also have this card. If you have four or more other rear guards, then this unit gets power plus 5k. So this is 15. Oh, sorry, you can't see him. My bad. So he is 15k only if you have four other units. So he doesn't count. So 1, 2, 3, and then you're gonna want like another unit here, and now he's 15k. So just imagine this board without persona riding. Okay, you can attack with this for 15, you can attack with this for this is 10 and this is 15, so maths 25. And now you can attack with Magnolia in this unit, boom, turn end, counter blast one. Now you can choose your Lettuce here and make another attack for about 25, I guess. Yeah, again, this is why I also mentioned why you want to be careful, because when you persona ride, only your front row units get the plus 10k. So for example, if you have weaker units in the front row, like for example, maybe you don't have this 10k base grade 2, that's just a 10k vanilla, by the way. Maybe you have this grade 1. Since Magnolia allows you to choose 3 units now in the back row to attack, you don't have to choose... you don't have to put like this grade 2 in front and the grade 1 in the back now, unless you want to boost, of course. You don't have to worry about that. Of course, your grade 2 will not be able to intercept in the back row, also keep that in mind, but that's still another attack. So now this gets 10k, so this is still hitting for 18. And then you have this other unit that if you choose not to use her skill to acquire boost, you can attack, and she's 15 as well. So, and you know, then you have Lettuce. So that's what I mean by being careful about your formation, especially when you persona ride. Which units do you really need to be, which units really need the power. You need to keep that in mind so that you can keep striking your opponent, and at the very least, you know, your units can hit. One defensive trigger can shut down your entire rush because your other units don't really get power, and because of that, most of your other units don't really get power. There's only a couple that do, so that's why you want to be careful. If your opponent checks a defense trigger, then some of your other units may not hit. Like Lettuce may hit, for example, but this grade one deer maybe will not hit because it's 18, for example, and they're at like 23 maybe or something. That's why you really need to think about your opponent, if your opponent can check a defense trigger or not, and then based on that decide what gets power and what to attack with, so that you can, at the very least, you can always hit the Vanguard. You can always attack them even if they guard. That still means you force them to guard, so be careful of that. Keep that in mind. You need a brain to play Stoichea, basically. Probably one of the more complex start decks, because it's, while it's still kind of simple, Sylvan King Magnolia still requires you to think a little bit more. And be careful, you can't just call something, and then swing. And again, Magnolia's kind of a drawback is that you need to Persona Ride in order to actually choose three or more. And that is sort of like a slight drawback, because if you don't get the Persona Ride, that does shut down your attack, kind of. You cannot really rush, you can only choose one other unit in the back row. But what is the deck, one of another unit unique things about this deck is that it only plays two of these blitz orders, but what it does is, and it's really good, so because this is a blitz order, you can play this by calling it to the Guardian Circle during your opponent's turn, which means when you're guarding. It's basically a quick shield, except that when you call this to the Guardian Circle for that battle, choose one of your units and gets power plus 5k. If you have three or more units in your back row, instead of 5k, it's actually 15. So it's 15k if you have 3 units already in your back row, which you will definitely want for your rush. So that's why, in case you're low on hand, you may want to call just anything to the back row, because you know that on your next turn, Magnolia can make it attack. So you just call anything to the back row, now you have 3, use this, you can give it to your Vanguard. 15k shield, just like that. Of course, Blitz Order, and since it's an Orc card, you can only play it once per turn as well, but still, it's a really good card. Unfortunately, there's only 2 copies of it in the start deck, but again, you can just buy singles and then swap out other cards. Like, for example, you can swap out this Grade 2 Vanilla for more of this really powerful order card. Just and it's an example, since they're both grade 2 after all. Okay, after this, we're gonna move on to the final one, that is Brandgate.